All right, guys, about to head into the second round of a Battle for Zendikar draft. We won in round one, 2-0. We have a red-white ally deck that seems pretty good. We have both the double strike one and the indestructible one, so it's pretty nice. Okay, this is a keep. I have a good two-drop, decent three-drop, and a nice combat trick, which works especially well with a guy like Core Castigator who has one toughness, so it's a definite keeper. Yeah, we will keep. Two drops and three drops are important. I wish I would have gotten one of those. I'm sure I passed many of them. Hopefully for things that were better than having a sandstone bridge. Looks like our opponent may also be red-white allies. Could also just be red-white other stuff, but looks possible. Yep, there's an ally. There's our double strike one. Play our Court Castigator and end our turn. We passed that one mana ally. I don't remember what we took over it. I think removal of some kind. Or maybe just a better creature, because I just didn't, you know, it's an okay one, but one mana, two ones aren't nearly as good in limited as they are in constructed. Retreat to Valakut. Okay. Not too concerned about that. All right, now we drew a three drop, which we already had one of, I guess. I think I'm gonna swing with my Castigator. If he blocks, you can get a lot more value out of Tandem Tactics when you're swinging with more than one thing, though. So I think I'm actually gonna play Tunneling GOP in my turn. This can make guys unblockable and make his guy +2/+0. That's fine with me. It's another card we passed instead of taking, obviously. Building up our board before Resolute Blademaster is also really nice, of course. See what our opponent does. If he plays a land, I'm guessing he makes his guy bigger, maybe. Next turn, I probably swing with both and then use Tandem Tactics if that's you know, an option. If he blocks. If he doesn't block, I won't use it and I'll just play out our Shadow Glider. Who I think should be an ally, but you know, it's not. Would be nice. All right, he does get a landfall trigger. Okay, he's making my GOP unable to block. Maybe about to play the Haste Ally. Well, I don't think we ever saw. At least not once. We pretty quickly went into red white when we first picked. What did we first pick? I don't even remember now. Hero of Gomafada was not our first pick, but we picked a white card, their first pick. We're gonna just take that. And then we second picked the Hero of Gomafada, and then we got Resolute Blademaster, so I was like, yeah, I guess we're gonna make an ally deck. I cannot remember what I took with my first pick, though, anymore. Oh, yeah, now I do. The Prairie Stream. Wow, we got two of those guys, huh? It's pretty nice. He's got lots of one mana allies, the kinds that we were passing a lot of that I'm not the huge fan of. Okay, so let's do one to him. We're gonna swing with both of these guys. There is a risk that he has his own trick, the two mana +3/+0 Sure Strike, I think it's called. But Tandem Tactics is still probably worth using unless he just takes six here, in which case we'll just play out our Shadow Glider. Okay, so he's probably going to be able to save one of them if he uses his Sure Strike. Let's assume he has a Sure Strike in his hand. But even if he does, we take down one of his creatures. It's a two for two, basically. And he has a lot less resources in his hand right now, so I think I'm okay with that. Mean, I didn't really need to use it to make the GOP run over the that guy, but you know, I wanted to use it to keep this dude alive anyway. So fine, one for one. If I can clear the board a little bit before I play my Blade Master, I'll be pretty happy. Seems like he's probably got something though, since he's thinking. Yeah, there's Sure Strike, which I thought was likely. Right. And then we end our turn there. Can't really do anything else, obviously. Too bad he had Sure Strike there. Reckless Cohort. Okay. These are all allies we didn't really want. So he's got a lot of them. I mean, at one Expedition Envoy wouldn't have been bad, obviously, but ooh, that's a little annoying though, that's for sure. Don't have any way to immediately punish him for that. Okay, we now have a Touch of the Void, which also can't really punish him for that. For now, I just play Shadow Glider. If he draws a land, he can pump his old team and get a landfall trigger. It's entirely possible, and that would be pretty bad right now. I mean, you know, I don't really want him drawing spells either. I don't want him to draw anything. So, okay, double retreat to Valakut's pretty weird, pretty gross. I wish I had one of those cubs right now. Here. I'm not sure what I'll do here. Stone Fury would be pretty great right now. Touch of the Voiding the Cliffside Lookout seems like a pretty good option on this next turn, depending on what else we draw. Yeah, now if he draws a land, okay, that's what he's deciding to do. Do I want to trade with the Expedition Envoy? I don't really think I do, but I think I'm going to and take four. Drop me to nine. Okay, well, that's not bad. It can trade with that guy, make my guy indestructible. All seems pretty good. Unless, of course, he draws a land, and then we're pretty close to dead. Yeah, I think I play it. Then next turn, Blade Master plus that is pretty gross, if we can get there. I just hope he doesn't draw a land or removal. If he draws a land, we're in a lot of trouble. If he doesn't, we're not in too much trouble yet. And I'll probably Touch of the Void that lookout on my next turn before I do anything else. He's got something, though, because he's thinking. I mean, trading a Hero of Gomafada for a Reckless Cohort kind of sucks, but at least it's a two for one. And there's the land. So he can make both of these unable to block. Yeah, it looks like that's what he's doing. Yeah, that's bad. Hits me for five that I can't do anything about. Now, because he's tapped out, I mean, doesn't have any cards in his hand, we can play Resolute Blade Master and hit him for 8, for 12, but that's not going to be enough. It's too bad we didn't hit him for a little bit of damage earlier. Stone Fury. Come on, Stone Fury. Well, another creature isn't bad, but I think I think I have to play the other creatures so that I can at least block something. And I think I'm going to play the Great Horn before I play the Blade Master. We just have to get through this. Hope he doesn't draw a bunch of lands and kill both of these creatures. That's all, no big deal. Tried an Evolving Wilds right now for this Undo Great Horn. Now, if he attacks with everything and we like block with the thing he lets us block with, I think we're relatively happy. And we Stone Fury, though, is pretty much the only thing in our deck that can deal with this Reckless Cohort, so. He has a bunch of 2/1s and 1/1s, so I'm probably actually going to side in the Stonehaven Medic against this guy. It seems like it would be a really good early blocker. Yeah, that's bad. Does that just end things, basically? I guess we'll see. He pumps a guy, and then he can pump his whole team, and he's going to make two creatures unable to block, I would guess. Yep. And we have to block the cohort. Those Retreat to Valakuts are definitely good against this against me right now. I don't normally like them a whole lot, but we're gonna go to two here. Or maybe not. He could have pumped his whole team there and done two to me. He probably should have. Okay, we've got 7 mana, which is not quite enough mana for us to both play Touch of the Void and a creature. So we just have to play a creature to try to make it to another turn. So we're going to play our Blade Master. Who, like, if we're lucky enough that he doesn't draw a land this turn or anything else that's especially bad for us, can definitely lead to us just winning in one swing if he makes some mistakes somewhere. We need an ally. We need to draw an ally to really make that work for us. But if he hits a land here, we again will drop to two or so. We'll drop to 2 life or 1 life, depending on whether he pumps his guy. So, but if he does play a land, oh, it looks like maybe he doesn't have a land. All right, finally made it through some land, didn't get a land drop that time. Okay, I'm gonna use Touch of the Void. Well, should I though? I should. There's no re He's not going to block if I swing. Like, there's no reason he would. So I think I'd rather just go Touch of the Void here. I was thinking about swinging and sort of forcing him into an awkward blocking situation, but it's not really worth it. And we're going to hold on to this land and end our turn. We can't swing with anything because if he just draws a land, we're dead. So we just have to keep hanging back. Have at least three creatures in play because he has two Retreat to Valakuts in play. Yep, and there's that. So he's going to force us to do an awkward block, probably kill off our Resolute Blade Master. I mean, I can double. Oh, no, I can't. I can't. I wish I could double block the thing, but yeah, we're gonna have to block with our double strike granting guy now. Maybe Retreat to Valakut's better than I was thinking. I don't know. So we're gonna block. Too bad I couldn't flash an ally in right there and like give my guys a double strike. Would have been nice. Core Castigator. All right, so we're in a situation where if he draws a land, we're dead. If he doesn't, we get one more turn. So let's see if he draws a land. If he drew a land, I think he already would have played it. So, because it's just game. Although he may be worried about what's in my hand, I guess. But there's no re like even if I do have a way to kill one of his creatures, it's not like swinging for three here with just his Castigator or whatever is a great. I mean, I'm dead anyway, so I don't know why I'd have to have two removal spells in my hand or tandem tactics or something to gain me life. Okay, he drew a creature, which does buy us the extra turn I was wanting. Okay. All right. I think I do just trade here. I don't think we have a hope if we don't, so we have to draw. You know, if he draws a land, we're dead, but that's been true for a while. So if I draw in removal there or something, yeah, that's game. Like, you know, because he had the retreat to Valakut in play anyway, it didn't really matter, like, what we did. So those double retreat to Valakuts were brutal. Okay, and I don't think I have any way of dealing with them in my sideboard. I didn't get any of the cubs that can blow up that thing. But I do think Stonehaven Medic is pretty good in this matchup. Undo Rising is probably not bad either. Question is, what do I take out for the Stonehaven Medics? Maybe like a Tunneling Geopede. Undo Greathorn seems like it blocks a lot of those guys really well. Of course, you know, it doesn't matter if he gets his crazy stuff in play, like he did last game. Maybe I'll just side in one. Yeah, I'm just gonna side in one. I don't want to take anything out a whole lot. So yeah, that's what we'll do. Gives us a good two-drop blocker against all of his one toughness dudes, who can also gain us some life, which can certainly be useful. Which is why I was considering Undo Rising too, because he tries to do so much damage to us all at once that gaining a little bit of life makes a pretty big difference. I would like to play first. And it's kind of a weird hand, but I think it's a keep. Don't have anything till turn three, but that's okay. We have two good four drops after that, and a decent. The three drop's not awful, so. He's probably going to play his one mana 2/1 ally, though. Seems likely. There it is. Oh, we drew a two drop. This guy has not been showing up as much as you'd expect a guy you have three of to show up. We didn't get him at all last game, but he's pretty great right now, obviously. Fortified Rampart, that's definitely a nuisance. All right. So we're gonna pump him up a bit. Play our McKindy Patrol. And we might as well swing with him, I mean. Why not? I'm sure he just blocks it since he knows I'm tapped out and everything, so. Maybe I should have swung before I played the patrol, although him having vigilance is relevant, I think. Well, that's interesting. I mean, it gives him a trade, but he didn't have to trade if he didn't want to. And I'm perfectly okay with that trade. So he could have just blocked there and nothing would have happened. He may have a lot of gas in his hand, I guess. Right, another one of those. Since we have all these land drops coming up, I'm going to play the Andu Greathorn before I play the Vestige of Emrakul. And I'll end the turn there. Dragon Master Outcast would be pretty great against this guy. He didn't seem to have a huge amount of removal. He just sort of swarmed me. So if Dragon Master Outcast could come into play and just start cranking out 5/5 dragons, I think he'd be in some trouble. Okay. Play a land. And then we're going to swing with both of these. Drops him to 16. And I'm going to play the Vestige of Emrakul because it's just so much bigger than his Expedition Envoy that it continues to create problems for him the same way that Greathorn just did, where he, the blocks were awkward other than if he blocked with Fortified Rampart. His own Resolute Blade Master, huh? That is a problem. Especially since we don't have removal right now. Okay, question is, do I trade my Vestige here? I don't think I do. I think I just take four. Oh, yes. That was a mean draw. Right after what he did to us, though. I mean, and we're going to give all our guys vigilance too, so it's not even dangerous. That's awesome. How do you like it? Everyone gets vigilance and double strike. Yeah, that's going to force some awkward blocks for him. He can just block McKindy Patrol, but everything else can just wreck him. Wow, he's just taking all of that. That's lethal if he's just taking it all. I think, yeah. Okay. I was like, am I that off on my math? Sometimes I am. Not right there, I wasn't. Okay. On to game three. Yeah, that was a pretty sweet top deck for us. Nothing else would have just like instantly won us the game like that. I don't think we make any more changes. Although Inspired Charge, can make my army of allies beat his army of allies as at instant speed, which isn't bad. We do have a lot of creatures, but what would I take out for it? Probably like a Sure Strike. Or a tandem tactics, and probably the tactics, because the Sure Strike is generally, yeah, I think I am going to put it in. The Sure Strike is generally easier to, get use as removal, basically. So, yeah. I think I like Inspired Charge as a way to finish him. So, on to game three. Can't believe he didn't block there. I guess he felt like, he was going to be forced to block and lose his own Blade Master, so, like, what was the point? But, ugh. No white mana, of course. So we're going to have to mulligan. And this one's okay. We do, and then putting that on the bottom. We do need mountain pretty bad, but we've got a 2-drop and a 3-drop. All right. This is a pretty great hand now because we can go Core Castigator into Fireman into Firemantle Mage, and then Makindi Patrol after that. And now we have Andu Champion as well. So we'll play our Castigator first. End our turn there. But I'll definitely. Well, it depends what he plays. If he plays a creature here, then playing the Makindi Patrol first is probably more worth it. Okay. Well, he's just going to go all in on that guy. I'm okay with that, I think. Would have been better to draw a mountain for our Andu champion, but I'm not going to complain too much, I don't think. Yeah, I'm trying to decide whether I'd play want to play Firemantle. I think I'll play the Makindi Patrol first, actually. Swing for three. Be able to use Inspired Charge soon enough to help deal with him. Okay, retreat to Valakut. All right. You gotta attack with your guy now, though. Mountain. Haha! I've been drawing pretty lucky draws, that's for sure. I want to play the Andu Champion because he can trade with that thing. And he gives my whole team trample in the future. And then Firemantle Mage coming down later is going to be like a big problem for our opponent. So the race is tied right now. I probably just trade with this if he doesn't do something like make my guy unable to block. Although, let's see, right now if I swing back at him and then Inspired Charge, it's 6, 10, it's lethal. So, that may be worth considering. Like, I probably wouldn't trade now, actually, if he just attacks with his Reckless guy. I'll use Inspired Charge to kill him, or try to anyway. Alright, he's going to make something unable to block and probably play something else after that, seems likely anyway. It's interesting. Ah, now that makes sense. Okay, well, we still just take four here. Okay, Stone Fury is just great right now. I'm just gonna kill the guy now, and that's because he could have a way to pump him and keep him alive for my Stone Fury on his own turn. And we get a 2-for-1, so I'm pretty happy with that. Also means his land drop this turn won't mean anything, and we get in for 5, drop him to 7. And if he only plays one creature next turn, we can just play Firemantle Mage, get the Menace, and hit him for 5 again. And then probably finish him with Inspired Charge. Depending on what else our opponent has in his hand. Okay, another Reckless Cohort. Is he gonna slap another aura onto him? No, Serene Steward. Okay. All right, that's pretty great though. So we're gonna play that, give our whole team indestructible, and swing with both of them. The Vigilance is actually really good against him because of his retreat to Valakut. Okay, that drops him to 2. See what he does now. I'm hoping. I mean, this is. Both of these decks are pretty explosive, so he could just kill me right here before I get a chance to kill him next turn. It's entirely possible. So. It's hard to know what'll happen here. He doesn't have to attack with his cohort anymore because he controls another ally. So if he has a land drop, he probably makes this unable to block. But then his attacks still aren't that good. I mean, I can just block here, and if he has a combat trick, that's fine. He doesn't have the five for Resolute Blademaster, which would really cause a problem. Okay, McKinney Patrol. That's pretty good against me right now too, because my Fire Mantle Mage. But I'm gonna play the Mage, make all my guys indestructible and menace, and I imagine that'll be a pretty big problem for my opponent. I won't win the game instantly, I don't think, but it'll be close. Okay. So we're gonna play our mage. Do I have my? No, I don't have the mana to play both. So I won't. But I guess I'll leave two wide up to bluff things or whatever. Said I'll leave two wide up. So we'll play Fire Mantle Mage. Gives my whole team menace, makes everyone indestructible, gives them all vigilance. So I don't think it instantly wins me the game, but he's going to be forced to do some blocks or die. You know, he has to block everything. No, it will win me the game because if any one of them hits him, he's dead. So I'm also going to play this. Make it look like we have Sure Strike or something. So we're going to swing with these. I think the menace just. Yeah, you can't block like that, buddy. Menace means you're dead. Because he has to double block here, and then he just can't block anything else, so that just finishes him off. That was a interesting ally matchup, that's for sure. He took a lot of the ones that we passed, so I think we got the more cream of the crop allies than he did. So works out for me. So we won round two with our ally deck, so we're gonna try to go 3-0 here in this draft. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like.